Welcome to the InfoWars Nightly News. Today's date is June 18th, 2013. I'm your host, Rob Dew, and it is a pleasure for me to be presenting the news to you today. And here is a list of our top stories.
Tonight on the InfoWars Nightly News, another government drill sees NORAD take over the skies of D.C. Then, the NFL sacks your privacy with their Clear Bag campaign. And Edward Snowden confirms he is not a Chinese spy. All that and more coming up on the InfoWars Nightly News.
The bad people want your info. What is your problem?
Well, from the league that brought you TSA pat-downs before you entered their games and drones in the skies and a continuation of the See Something, Say Something program, the TSA combined with DHS has now decided to ban bags at their games. That's right. You will not believe this. This is from a Don Salazar. NFL to enhance public safety by implementing clear bag policy. I can barely say it because it freaks me out so much. In an effort to enhance public safety and improve stadium access for fans, the National Football League is getting set to ban all bags and purses that are not see-through in its 32 stadiums across the U.S. There's an FAQ at the NFL.com/all-clear, appropriately named, a cynical play on the military term which represents a signal when a threat of danger has passed, is all too obvious. They're actually going to have a buffer area of bag police there. Okay, so now we have bag police to be checking on things. There will also be a secondary perimeter where agents will be scurrying around telling you not to bring bags in. And I think it's just very apropos if you scroll down in the article and look at, you can actually see pictures on NFL.com's site on their own store where they sell bags that are not even see-through. So they're selling these $30 plus bags that you will never be able to take and bring in to show your support for the team. Not only that, it gets worse. On their FAQ, there's a question. And there's the picture right there of the bags that you won't be able to take in to their stadiums. Are seat cushions allowed to be carried into the stadium? This is right under the pictures here. No, they are not, due to their large size, because of the way seat cushions are constructed, would allow them to be used to conceal a potential explosive device. Well, let me just say this. Thank God they've implemented this. So now they can't launch a false flag of a seat cushion bomber. That's the only plus I could think of them not having seat cushions at NFL games. Let me tell you, I've been to a few NFL games. The seats are not very comfortable. And now you won't be able to bring your favorite little cushion to sit on with your team logo. Pretty soon they're probably going to outlaw team logos. They're going to say that could be seen as a terrorist threat. I'm not kidding. Moving on, this is a that was at a Don Salazar story, by the way. Very good, by the way. Kurt Nemo writes the next one. NORAD's Falcon Virgo exercise rolls out today in D.C. On June 17th, the Office Assistant Secretary of Defense for Public Affairs announced NORAD exercise for Washington, D.C. to be held today, June 18th, and tomorrow, June 19th. Exercise Falcon Virgo is designed to hone NORAD's intercept and identification operations. And you know how well that looked and that worked during 9/11. And what I like about this article, it goes through a whole list of how the NORAD stand downs took place and the people that actually brought that out. In the section, previous exercises did nothing to prevent 9/11. It concludes with Secretary of Transportation at the time, Norman Mineta's testimony before the National Commission on Terrorist Attacks, where he talked about on May 23, 2003, he said, "I was made aware of it during the time that the airplane was coming into the Pentagon. There was a young man who had come in and said to the vice president, 'The plane is 50 miles out. The plane is 30 miles out.' And when it got to 'The plane is 10 miles out,' the young man said to the vice president, 'Do the orders still stand?' And the vice president turned, whipped his neck around and said, 'Of course they still stand. Have you heard anything to the contrary?'" That was my Dick Cheney impersonation. Mineta's testimony was also corroborated by counterterrorism chief Richard Clark and also reported by Bob Woodward. And so it concludes, "No number of carefully planned and closely controlled exercises will prevent another 9/11 attack, as the Pentagon claims. If NORAD is ordered to stand down as it was obviously was on September 11, 2012. So that's what it goes back to. This article is kind of like, well, here is a piece of information that's new. And then what we do at InfoWars is try to go back and point out where the government lied to you, where they tried to mislead you, and especially with that whole NORAD timeline of when they knew, when the FAA informed them, was there a stand-down order? Why were the jets sent across country where they couldn't be of any help? You know, there's all kind of stuff going on with 9/11. I encourage you to look at it if you don't know anything about it before you call me a crazy conspiracy theorist.
Now you can watch Alex Jones live at InfoWars.com/show.
You'll find links to all of our content there and a free 15-day trial for Prison Planet TV.
You can also browse the network, the InfoWars Nightly News,
and over 60 movies and documentaries all together in one place.
You can watch the Alex Jones Radio Show live as it happens.
So check it out, InfoWars.com/show.